That means the input voltage is fed to the positive terminal of the comparator. Positive terminal of the comparator, right? And the negative terminal is connected to reference voltage. Okay, so at that condition, this is called as positive voltage comparator or non-inverting type comparator. Okay, non-inverting type comparator, where the input voltage is fed to the positive terminal or non-inverting terminal, and the negative terminal is connected to the referencing negative terminal is connected with respect to a reference voltage. Reference voltage. So this is the term where we come across V1 is connected to the input voltage and V2 is connected to a reference voltage. So if we observe the behavior of our output voltage waveform, so this is the reference pulse. This is the reference pulse and this is the input voltage. So in previous discussion, we discussed about sinusoidal pulse, and we also analyzed with respect to triangular pulse. So this is the discussion where we analyzing the non-inverting type comparator or positive comparator with the negative with a triangular pulse. Is the triangular pulse or a sawtooth pulse? See here, this is a sawtooth pulse and this is the reference voltage. Okay, so when a condition where the input voltage here, we can see three instants. This is the zeroth instant and this is first instant and this is the second instant. And again, here comes the zeroth instant. So here, that means what I'm saying is here we are considering the positive peak of triangular pulse. Okay, and that positive peak of triangular pulse is compared with respect to a reference waveform or a reference voltage pulse. Okay, if the input voltage is less than the reference voltage, input voltage is less than the reference voltage, at that condition the output is low. See here, the output is low. Okay, after the input voltage is came in contact with respect to the reference pulse, okay, there is a build in the output voltage with respect to it is traveling towards high. Okay, so whenever the input voltage, this peak of the sawtooth waveform or the triangular waveform, the input voltage is greater than the reference pulse, at that condition we can observe output voltage as plus V saturation. This is called, at this condition it is plus V saturation, or it is discussed as high. Okay, and after again the input voltage came in contact with respect to the reference pulse and it is going towards the zeroth instant, and again the output pulse drops to low. And if the input here, see, the input voltage is greater than reference pulse and again the output is low. That means what we are saying here, so at each and every instant, if the input voltage is less than reference voltage, the output voltage will stay as in a low condition. And if the input voltage is greater than the reference voltage, then at that condition output voltage is plus V saturation, or it is termed as high. Okay, if the input voltage is if the input voltage is again less than the reference voltage, here we have a low term, or it is called as minus V saturation. So this is what we analyzed with respect to the behavior of a positive comparator or non-inverting type comparator, where the input voltage is connected with respect to the non-inverting terminal or positive terminal. That's why it is called positive comparator or non-inverting type comparator. So same discussion is happened with respect to inverting type comparator. Okay, if we analyze the input negative comparator or negative voltage comparator or inverting comparator, what we did means here the input voltage is connected with respect to the negative terminal or inverting terminal. That's why it is called as inverting comparator or negative voltage type comparator. Okay, and the reference voltage is connected to the positive terminal. Okay, so if we compare this input voltage to the reference voltage, that's what a comparator do. Name in the self is saying comparator, in the sense it will compare the input analog voltage to a reference pulse. It's a comparison of input voltage with respect to reference pulse. It is a comparison of V1 with respect to V2, or V2 with respect to V1. Okay, V2 with respect to V2, or V2 with respect to V2, or V1 with respect to V1. Okay, so that means here the input voltage is compared with respect to the reference voltage, and the output voltage is observed with our operational amplifier. That application is called as comparator. So here the input voltage is connected to the negative terminal or inverting terminal. That's why it is called inverting type comparator or negative voltage comparator. Okay, so here the output voltage is observed. So what is the expression of output voltage? Output voltage is proportional to VID, where VID is nothing but difference of input voltage and reference voltage. Same, if we see the output voltage analysis, here the output voltage, see in the input voltage is triangular pulse and a reference pulse is observed here. Same, input voltage, if the input voltage is less than the reference voltage, input voltage is less than the reference voltage, the output voltage is at positive V saturation or high. Okay, and if the input voltage is greater than, input voltage is greater than reference voltage, the output voltage is at, the output voltage is at low or at minus V saturation condition. Most of the condition that is called as low. And again, the input voltage is less than the reference voltage, here we have again positive saturation or high. That means the condition, the output voltage is analyzed with respect to the behavior of input voltage with respect to reference pulse. Okay, if the input voltage is less than reference voltage at this condition, the output is high, and if the input voltage is greater than the reference voltage, the output is low. That means this is a vice versa condition with respect to positive comparator and negative comparator, which is opposite. So two comparators, positive voltage comparator is having there its assumptions of output voltage analysis, negative voltage comparator is having its analysis of output voltage expressions. Okay, so that is about two type of comparators we discussed about. So coming to the next type of application is a window comparator. We discussed about window comparator. Here we involved two comparators, okay, two operational amplifiers are involved like comparators. So this is comparator one and this is comparator two. Okay, so the output voltage is analyzed in the form of a positive high. This is called as a positive high, or it is called as a window. That's why by observing the output voltage analysis, we call this as a window comparator. Okay, two amplifiers are analyzed here, connected here. See, two amplifiers are connected with respect to an input supply. Okay, first amplifier A1 is connected to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. This is called as an inverting comparator or negative voltage comparator. A1 is a inverting comparator or negative voltage comparator, right? A2 is nothing but positive voltage comparator or non-inverting type comparator. And the reference pulse of A1 is connected to non-inverting terminal and the reference pulses of A2 is connected to inverting terminal. Okay, see how there is a potential divider connected to the other side. See how this reference voltages are tapped. These reference voltages are nothing but the biased voltages, see. Plus VCC and minus VEE. Minus VEE terminals are grounded. A1 minus VEE terminals and A2 minus VEE terminals are grounded. Okay, so if we see here, the output voltages is observed with respect to V0. The output voltage is observed with respect to V0 of the operational amplifier. And the biased voltages are fed as a reference pulses. Three potential dividers at that first initial end of potential divider. Here the biased voltage is 1/3 of VCC, which is given as a reference pulse to second operational amplifier. Okay, and at the second resistance of the potential divider top, we are having 2/3 VCC. That means 2/3 VCC of reference pulse is given as an input to the inverting type operational amplifier, that is A1. Okay, and here we have 3/3 VCC, that is nothing but plus VCC. Okay, that means the biased voltage is fed as a reference voltage at 1/3 ratio at each tapping of this particular potential divider circuit. So why this thing happened means with the help of this application, okay, with the type of this application we can apply two reference pulses of same rating, that is the rating is nothing but the rating of biased voltage which is proposed here in the circuit. So that is about circuit construction. Whereas RL is nothing but load resistance. So the input voltage is nothing but the triangular pulse is fed to the input voltage of the comparator A1 and A2. Okay, and the reference pulses, two reference pulses. One is 1/3 reference pulse is applied to A2 and a 2/3 reference pulse is applied to A1. Okay, so at what condition we will get this particular positive shot or this type of window condition means, see here. Okay, when the at the first instant at the zeroth instant we don't see any output voltage, and output voltage will stay slow. Okay, when the input voltage intersects in between two reference pulses, okay, this is very very important in a window comparator. Listen very carefully. When the input voltage intersects here with respect to the two comparators, at that condition we can clearly see there is a positive shot. We can clearly see a positive shot with respect to the output waveform of the comparator. That is nothing but a behavior called window at this condition, at this region, when the input voltage intersects with respect to the input voltage intersects with respect to two reference pulses of upper reference pulse and lower reference pulse, we can clearly see a occurrence of window at this condition. This is called as positive high or positive short. Okay, and after the input voltage at the first instant input voltage is not even intersecting with any reference pulse and output stays slow, and at the second instant input voltage intersects with respect to two reference voltages, here we have a window type of output voltage, and that is positive V saturation or high, and at the third instant the input voltage is quite greater than two reference pulses, and again here we have seen a behavior of low output voltage. At the fourth instant again the input voltage is dropping, and again input voltage intersects with respect to two reference pulses, and again here we have seen a positive saturation or positive short here. Okay, this is our second window, and again at the last instant there is no intersection of output voltage, and there is no intersection of output voltage with respect to input voltage with respect to the reference pulse. That's why again it is low. That means what we can see means, whenever the input voltage is intersecting with respect to the reference pulses, we can clearly see a window type pulse in the output voltage condition or output voltage saturation, a positive high of or positive saturation of output voltage with respect to the reference input voltage, and the reference, that means the input voltage is came in contact with respect to the two reference pulses. At that condition here we have positive high at two conditions. We are observing it clear windows or positive highs. So this output waveform here we can see two positive saturations and two window type structures. That's why this application is called window comparator. So this is the first application of nonlinear operational amplifier, mostly in the applications of comparator. So if you have any doubts, just post them in the chat box in our discussion. So this is the most important application of comparators, that is a zero crossing detector. So zero crossing detector, clearly we can see this is an open loop circuit. Open loop circuit in the sense the output voltage is maximum. Output voltage is infinite in ideal conditions, but in practical condition we can't describe the infinite situation here. That's why we represent that with a saturation value. That means the infinite behavior of open loop gain in practical condition is represented with respect to saturation values. Saturation value is nothing but the normal general termination, it is called as maximum value. Okay, in our literature we call that maximum value as saturation value. Okay, that means we can't represent the infinite behavior of operational amplifier directly in our theoretical structures, in our analysis point of view. That's why we are analyzing that maximum or infinite condition with respect to positive saturation and negative saturation. So coming into the application of a zero crossing detector, so zero crossing detector is a initial application to the square wave generator. We have seen various square wave generators like zero crossing detectors, skimmed triggers, monostable multivibrators. Coming into monostable multivibrators also, we have seen a stable multivibrator, monostable multivibrator, and logarithmic amplifiers, like logarithmic amplifiers and anti-logarithmic amplifiers. So this is a initial square wave generator. First analysis of square wave generator is explained with respect to zero crossing detector, which is a primary example of comparator. So if we analyze the circuit, so this is our comparator operational amplifier, which is constructed in an open loop feedback circuit. You don't have any feedback here. Okay, so the positive terminal is connected with respect to the reference voltage and grounded, and the negative terminal is connected with respect to input voltage. So what type of comparator means? This is a negative voltage comparator or negative type comparator or inverting comparator. Okay, we are comparing here the input voltage with respect to reference voltage. Okay, the input voltage is compared with respect to reference voltage. See here, the reference voltage observed is zero. The reference voltage observed is zero, and the behavior of input voltage is sinusoidal. Sinusoidal, and that means the instantaneous voltage, the sinusoidal voltage is applied to the input terminals of the operational amplifier. See the output in the behavior of output voltage pulse, we can clearly see a sinusoidal instantaneous voltage pulse. Okay, sinusoidal pulse we have seen. So in the at that particular sinusoidal pulse, see here in the analysis, here we have a positive peak and a negative peak. Positive peak and negative peak. That means the input voltage oscillates in between the positive peak and negative peak in a peculiar sinusoidal structure. Okay, that means we are comparing that sinusoidal structure into a square wave generator. How that going to happen means with respect to the principle of operation of zero crossing detector. So whenever this input voltage came across with respect to the reference pulse, okay, what is the behavior of reference pulse? The reference pulse is zero. So whenever the input voltage came across with respect to the reference pulse, okay, so at that instant there used to be a change in behavior of the output voltage. That means whenever the input voltage is at positive peak, the output voltage is experiencing at negative saturation condition. Okay, and again the input voltage is varying from positive peak and it is reaching the zeroth instant. At that condition, the output voltage switches from negative saturation to positive saturation. That means here the output voltage swings from negative saturation towards positive saturation whenever the positive peak is moving from positive structure towards its negative structure. Okay, and again the negative peak, here we can observe a negative peak. At that condition, the output voltage is positive saturation. Okay, that means this is a simultaneous manner. That means here we can see the behavior of output voltage swing. The behavior of output voltage swing. The output voltage is swinged or oscillated from positive saturation to negative saturation. And again positive saturation to negative saturation. Again negative saturation to positive saturation. So this application of square wave generation is happened with respect to zero crossing detector principle. That means whenever the input voltage crosses the instant zero, at that condition, the output voltage will swing from its initial instant to other instant. Okay, whenever the input voltage is at positive peak, the output voltage is at negative saturation. Whenever the output voltage is switching from its positive peak towards the negative peak, and again, the output voltage is swinging from minus V saturation to positive V saturation. So this is the application of a zero crossing detector. The major limitation with respect to zero crossing detector is it is having a certain amount of noise disturbance at the output voltage swing. Okay, that means the noise immunity system of zero crossing detector is not good. Okay, it is having very low noise immunity, less noise immunity system. And the second thing is at low frequency applications we can't employ zero crossing detector. So these are the limitations. In order to eliminate these limitations, we are proposing a second major application to the operational amplifier that is called as Schmitt trigger. That is called as Schmitt trigger or regenerative comparator. Regenerative comparator. Some of the literatures we will call that as a Schmitt trigger. In some of the literatures they call with a term called regenerative comparator. Why it is called regenerative comparator means here we proposed a positive feedback. Positive feedback. If we compare the zero crossing detector with respect to the Schmitt trigger, there is no feedback circuit with the zero crossing detector, but here we have a feedback circuit that is positive feedback. That's why it is called as regenerative comparator. A positive feedback circuit is used here in the concept of Schmitt trigger. A Schmitt trigger is analyzed with respect to two types, two classifications. One is inverting Schmitt trigger and second one is a non-inverting type Schmitt trigger. Inverting Schmitt trigger, we know what is meant by an inverting comparator or a negative voltage comparator. If it is an inverting type application, means always the input voltage is connected to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier, that is nothing but our inverting terminal. Okay, and here the positive feedback is connected to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Okay, so if we analyze this particular behavior of operation, here the feedback circuit R1 and R2, feedback circuit is having two resistances R1 and R2. Okay, and the non-inverting terminal is grounded. Okay, with the concept of virtual grounding, the terminal voltage of the terminal voltage here V2 is equal to V1, and V1 is equal to V2 equal to zero. The input voltage is fed with respect to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. The input voltage is sinusoidal, and the resistances R1 and R2. The resistances R1 and R2, here what they are doing, they are producing two reference voltages. Two reference voltages. One is upper threshold voltage and another one is lower threshold voltage. These two upper threshold voltages and lower threshold voltages, these two are proposed with respect to two resistances. One is R1 and R2. One is R1 and R2. R1 and R2. Two feedback resistors are used here. So if we analyze the analysis of Schmitt trigger, the output voltage of Schmitt trigger here, see, the input voltage here we observed is sinusoidal pulse. The input voltage here we observed is sinusoidal pulse, which is observed where we can see the behavior of two input, two reference voltages. One is upper threshold voltage VUT or higher threshold voltage or maximum threshold voltage. Okay, and second one is lower threshold voltage or minimum threshold voltage or less threshold voltage, that is represented as VLT. Okay, see here, at 0th instant, from the 0th instant to 1, from 0 to 1, we can clearly see that the input voltage is less than, the input voltage is less than upper threshold value. At that condition, here we have a positive saturation. Okay, at the second instant from 1 to 1, at second instant 1, the input voltage is greater than upper threshold value, upper threshold voltage. At that condition, the output voltage is low. Output voltage is low, or it is at minus V saturation condition. That means even though the input voltage crossed with respect to the upper threshold voltage, okay, it is in transition from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage. This period is called transition period. Even though it is in a transition period, the output voltage is not swinged from minus V saturation to positive V saturation condition. The output voltage is still present in minus V saturation condition at the transition period also. Okay, after the input voltage came across in contact with respect to the second terminal contact at the second point, that means the input voltage came in contact with respect to the lower threshold voltage. At that condition, the output voltage swinged from minus V saturation condition to positive V saturation condition, that is called as high. Okay, and again the input voltage just swings, and it is came across to lower threshold voltage, and it is in a transition instant. See here, this is the transition instant. At that condition also, the output voltage is at positive V saturation condition, and again the output voltage came across with respect to upper threshold value. At that condition, okay, at that condition, the input voltage is greater than, it is input voltage is moving greater than the upper threshold value. At that condition, the output is at minus V saturation condition. Okay, this entire analysis of output voltage is clearly explained with respect to a hysteresis loop. Hysteresis loop. This hysteresis loop is analyzed with respect in the form of a transition transfer characteristics. These transfer characteristics of inverting type Schmitt trigger are analyzed with respect to output voltage and the input voltage. Output voltage is denoted on y-axis and the input voltage denoted on x-axis. Okay, so one side we have the behavior of upper threshold voltage, and another side we have the behavior of lower threshold voltage. That means at this instant, see, at this instant of this quadrant, when the input voltage is less than the upper threshold value, the output voltage is at positive saturation. Output voltage is high. And again, the input voltage, if we keep on increasing the input voltage, the input voltage came in contact with respect to upper threshold value. At that condition also, here we have positive saturation. And again, if we decrease, and the input voltage is moving towards the negative peak, see, the input voltage is moving towards the negative peak, so see the direction, and the input voltage is greater than, came in contact with respect to lower threshold value, the output voltage is at negative saturation condition, and the input voltage is moving towards the lower threshold value, and it is crossing the lower threshold value, and next it meted towards the upper threshold value, it is at positive saturation condition. That means here the transfer characteristics, or this particular hysteresis characteristics, is analyzed with respect to a behavior called as dead band. Dead band is analyzed with respect to hysteresis voltage. How we analyze the hysteresis voltage means, hysteresis voltage is the difference of upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. Okay, so that's we analyze it with respect to the a particular transfer characteristic with respect to output equation. Input voltage is equal to feedback voltage, that is equal to V naught, output voltage into, with respect to the ratio of resistances, R1 and R2, that is R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, so from this circuit, the output voltage is at positive V saturation when it comes across with respect to upper threshold value. That's why V naught is at positive V saturation. We defined upper threshold value and lower threshold value here. And next we calculated the behavior of hysteresis voltage. Hysteresis voltage is nothing but a difference of upper threshold voltage with respect to lower threshold voltage. Okay, we calculated the difference between upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage, and we calculated the hysteresis. Here we can see hysteresis of a dead band is nothing but twice of saturation value with respect to a ratio of resistance of inverting type comparator. So if we analyze the non-inverting type comparator, the behavior of non-inverting type comparator, non-inverting comparator, name itself saying, the input voltage is connected to the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Sorry, non-inverting terminal, the input voltage is connected to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier, and the reference voltage is connected to the inverting terminal here. Okay, so if we analyze, the input voltage is sinusoidal, with the help of same positive feedback is connected with respect to the resistance R2, and the input resistance is R1 here. With the help of R1 and R2 ratio of resistance, R1 divided by R1 plus R2, we are providing two reference pulses. One is upper threshold value and lower threshold value. Upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. Okay, see, from 0 to 1, when the input voltage is below upper threshold voltage, input voltage is below upper threshold voltage, at that condition, we can see a negative saturation condition, which is quite opposite to inverting type comparator. Here the analysis is quite vice versa. Okay, so when the input voltage is less than upper threshold value at inverting type comparator, we observed a positive saturation. Here we are observing negative saturation. It is complete vice versa condition. And again, after the input voltage is greater than upper threshold value, here we have positive saturation. Okay, so here also at the transition period, we can observe at the transition period in the sense, even though input voltage crossed with respect to the upper threshold value, input voltage is not in any region to the reference pulse. At that condition, the behavior of output voltage is exhibiting same as the previous condition. That's why this period is called as transition period. In the transition period, the behavior of output voltage is same as previous condition. The output is experiencing output is shown as positive saturation until the input voltage came in contact with respect to a lower threshold value. Okay, and again, the input voltage came in contact with respect to lower threshold voltage. Here we can see a negative saturation, and this condition, next the input voltage is greater than lower threshold value. Here we have negative saturation, and even the input voltage crosses with respect to the lower threshold value, and it is increasing towards the positive peak, it not even came across cross with respect to upper threshold value. That means at the transition stage also, at this particular transition stage also, here we have negative saturation. That means after the input voltage came in contact with respect to the upper threshold value, at that condition only here we have positive saturation. Okay, so if we analyze with respect to the transfer characteristic with respect to V input and V output, see here the input voltage, the transfer characteristics are drawn between the x axis input voltage and y axis we have seen the output voltage. When the input voltage is greater than the upper lower threshold value, input voltage is greater than the lower threshold value, here we can see a positive saturation. So see the direction, and again at a positive saturation, and again input voltage is less than lower threshold value, at that condition we have negative saturation. Again input voltage is less than upper threshold value, it is going towards negative saturation. Here that means the hysteresis voltage, again here it is analyzed with respect to a difference between upper threshold value and lower threshold value as we analyzed before. If we observe the behavior of output voltage expression here, so here we have seen a particular KVL structure, voltage drop across input voltage and voltage drop across the output voltage. Okay, the input voltage minus 0 divided by R1 and output voltage 0 minus V0 divided by R2. So this is the input voltage with respect to output voltage. So if we see the behavior of input voltage is equal to minus of R1 divided by R2 into V0. So how we analyze it, this means the drop across R1 and drop across R2. Drop across R1, V input minus 0 divided by R1. Okay, V output minus 0 divided by R2. Okay, this is the concept of virtual ground. At the concept of virtual ground, V1 is equal to V2. Input voltage is equal to feedback voltage. That's why here the point is 0. Here the voltage at this terminal is 0. That's why drop across the resistance R1 is, okay, V1 divided by R1. V1 minus 0 divided by R1 and V0 minus 0 divided by R2. Not minus 0 divided by R2. So from that analysis we have defined input voltage and output voltage. Okay, so we know that if the input voltage is at upper threshold value, the output voltage is at negative saturation condition, the upper threshold voltage is analyzed here like this. Upper threshold is equal to R1 divided by R1 plus R1 divided by R2 into V saturation. And if the condition of lower threshold value, input voltage is equal to lower threshold value, and the output voltage swings from positive to negative to positive, here the output is plus V saturation. So this is the final expression. VL lower threshold voltage is equal to minus of R1 divided by R2 into V saturation condition. So if we observe the ratio, here, V hysteresis is equal to R1 divided by R2 into V saturation plus R1 divided by R2 into V saturation. If we subtract both of them, the output voltage hysteresis is equal to 2 into R1 divided by R2 into V saturation. That means here we analyze two type of Schmitt triggers, that is inverting type Schmitt trigger and non-inverting type Schmitt trigger. We can clearly say the Schmitt trigger which we observed or which we analyzed is having strong noise immunity system. It is even applicable for low frequency applications. So this is the second application of a square wave generator. Why it is having strong immunity system means we proposed the concept with the positive feedback system. Previously in the concept of zero crossing detector, there is no positive feedback system. Okay. And second thing is here we are having the two resistances R1 and R2. So with the help of a potential divider type ratio resistance, this particular Schmitt trigger, inverting Schmitt trigger or non-inverting Schmitt trigger, it is used for low frequency applications also. So coming into the next application is operational amplifier as multi-vibrator. Multi-vibrator in the sense, it is having different two operating regions mostly. So a stable multi-vibrator, this stable multi-vibrator is quite similar to our Schmitt trigger. But the concept is we don't take any external input supply. The input supply is taken directly from the output of the operational amplifier. Okay, the output is observed with respect to a negative feedback circuit, RC circuit, and it is next fed as an input to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. negative terminal of the operational amplifier. Okay, practically it is an inverting type schematic trigger. Input voltage is connected to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. It is a practical, it is an inverting type schematic trigger, or it is an negative voltage type comparator. Negative voltage type comparator, right? It is an inverting type comparator. And if we, how can we analyze the behavior of this output circuit? Means, see here, an RC pole pair is, RC pair is connected to the output from the output terminal or the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. And next, by respect to the capacitor charging and discharging. So previously the output voltage is at plus V saturation condition. At that condition, the capacitor is charged from zero to, it is going towards upper threshold value. Here the upper threshold value and lower threshold value are observed with the potential divider, which is connected at the positive feedback circuit. Okay. So and upper, if the input voltage came in contact with respect to the upper threshold voltage, if it increases a minute millivolts beyond upper threshold voltage, okay, the output voltage will swing from positive V saturation to negative V saturation. And again, at the time the capacitor will start discharging through the feedback resistance of RF. Okay, and again the capacitor will start discharging here. The capacitor will start discharging here. And again the capacitor came in slight contact with respect to the lower threshold voltage. Came in contact with respect to the lower threshold voltage, the output voltage again swings from negative V saturation to positive V saturation. Same. That means the output voltage is swinged its structure. The output voltage swings from negative saturation to positive saturation to negative saturation, depends upon the capacitor charging and discharging. That means the output voltage is clearly depending upon the charging time and of capacitor and the discharging time of capacitor. That means the total time period is analyzed or calculated with respect to charging and discharging of the capacitor here. That means here we can see a swing in the output voltage, oscillation in the output voltage with respect to the capacitor behavior. That means see here, the when again from the lower threshold voltage, the capacitor is charging towards the upper threshold voltage. Charging towards the upper threshold voltage. If the charging voltage increases a millivoltage beyond the upper threshold value, again the output voltage will drop from positive saturation to negative saturation. And again, at that condition of negative saturation, the capacitor will discharge. And if again, if the capacitor discharges a certain millivolt greater than this lower threshold value, and again the output voltage will swing from negative saturation to positive saturation. Okay, that means the oscillation or swinging of output voltage depends upon capacitor charging and discharging. So that's what we analyzed in our theoretical manner. That's what we analyzed in our output voltage expression with respect to this with respect to the capacitor transient time response. We capacitance of output voltage across capacitor Vc of t, that is equal to V maximum plus of initial voltage minus maximum voltage, voltage minus maximum voltage into exponential of law of minus t by RC. Okay, that means if we analyze this particular behavior, maximum voltage is came with respect to positive saturation. Okay, maximum voltage is analyzed with respect to positive saturation, and minus t is analyzed with respect to total charging time when capacitor reaches from upper threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage. And VLT is nothing but initial voltage, and VC of t is nothing but instantaneous voltage. If we rewrite the expression and if we solve, we can calculate capital T1. Capital T1, what is capital T1? Capital T1 is nothing but time taken from the capacitor to charging from lower threshold voltage to higher threshold voltage or upper threshold voltage. So same time it will take the capacitor to reach from higher threshold voltage to lower threshold voltage. So the total time period is analyzed with respect to capital T is equal to 2T1. Okay, that means capital T is equal to twice of RC into ln of positive V saturation minus negative V saturation condition. So that is about a stable multivibrator. A stable multivibrator is having two operating regions. One is that it will operate at stable condition at first instant, and its second operating condition is at quasi stable condition. So here, but at monostable condition, it have only one shot vibrator. That means it have only one stable state. Okay, one stable state, and the second stable state is quasi stable state. Quasi stable state in the sense temporary stable condition or temporary stable state. It is also called as one shot multi vibrator. Okay, and again it is similar to the inverting type Schmitt trigger. We analyze it with respect to inverting type comparator. The output voltage is taken with respect to RC circuit. Depending upon the capacitor charge and discharge, we will apply the input voltage to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. Here we have external triggering mechanism. This clamping, this diode is D1 is called clamping diode, and these two are D0 diodes. This and this rectifier diode D2. These are all called as external triggering mechanism. With the help of this external triggering mechanism, we are applying a negative shot to this terminal. To this terminal, previously before applying a negative shot, the output voltage is at positive saturation condition, and the diode voltage is at VD1, and this is the behavior of voltage here. After that means the entire output voltage is in stable condition, and it is almost towards reaching towards the quasi stable. At that quasi stable region, when the monostable multi vibrator is in quasi stable condition, we applied a negative shot. We applied a negative shot here. So by applying that negative shot, what happened means, okay, the capacitor will reach towards the negative saturation condition. It will came across with respect to the lower threshold value, and with respect to that tilting, the output voltage is at minus V saturation. This total time period capital T at minus V saturation condition is called as quasi time period. That means output, that means the multi vibrator at monostable multi vibrator is having a quasi stable condition. Okay, and next it reached towards, and the capacitor reached towards the lower threshold value, and if we increase a millivolts, next the output voltage will switch from positive saturation. At that condition, here the output voltage will swing from negative saturation to positive saturation. The system will go to stable condition. That means previously the system is at quasi stable condition. Quasi stable in the sense it is not stable, it is operating in a temporary stable region. Okay, this is the analysis with respect to monostable multivibrator. Monostable multivibrator, and we analyzed the output voltage with respect to the behavior of capacitor voltage. That is V suffix C is equal to positive V saturation plus diode voltage across diode at minus V saturation condition. At an exponential charge of capacitor charging and discharging. Okay, and we analyzed the behavior of total time period. Okay, so these are all nothing but the square wave generators, Schmitt trigger, zero crossing detectors, monostable multivibrator and stable multivibrators. These are all square wave generators. What is the difference between multivibrator and Schmitt trigger? Means Schmitt trigger will operate at external input supply. Multivibrators will operate with the own input supply, which is derived from the output. So here our concept is a triangular wave generator. A triangular wave generator is connected with respect to a square wave generator, is seriously connected with respect to an integrator. That means, what does an integrator do? Integrator output voltage is integral of input. That means if we give a square wave output voltage with the help of a square wave generator, that square wave generator is integrated with the help of integrator, and the output voltage is nothing but triangular wave generator. So previously we analyzed various square wave generators, zero crossing detector, Schmitt trigger, and stable multivibrator, monostable multivibrator. I am connecting a stable multivibrator here as a square wave generator, and that output of square wave generator is that is nothing but a square wave which is fed to the particular integrator. That integrator will take this square wave generator and it will integrate, and the output voltage is nothing but square wave generator. So this is the voltage, output voltage. If we analyze the output voltage, the input voltage is given, is the input voltage with respect to the integrator is output voltage of square wave generator, that is a square wave. So whenever a square wave is connected here, whenever a square wave is connected to the integrator, so at the positive peak of square wave, here we can clearly analyze a drop with respect to the ramp wave. A negative peak of ramp wave is observed at from the output to volt- when the output voltage is switching from positive saturation to negative saturation. That means here, whenever the square wave is whenever a square wave input is connected to the integrator, so what is the principle of integrator? The output voltage of integrator is proportional to the integral of input, and that input voltage is square wave. That input voltage is converted to triangular wave generator, triangular pulse. This is what the concepts we analyzed.